Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we have new acquisition in TNA from a couple months ago. We have the immortal Hulk Hogan.
Brother. Thanks, Conan, brother. It's great to be here, Conan, brother. You can ask the question now, brother. I'm ready to go, brother.
So, are you a good guy?
What, brother? Are you getting the holster, brother? Listen, brother. When the camera's on, brother, I'm a great guy, brother. But when the camera's off, ho, brother! It's a different story, brother.
Okay. What about you and this, Sting?
Well, let me tell you something, brother. Sting here, brother, he's a great guy, brother. Except when he took the bat, brother. And he smashed the man with the large arms in the world, brother. But you see, brother, the Hulkster's got a philosophy, brother. He's only gonna wrestle the big towns, brother. And he's gonna take the Stinger in the big towns, brother. And you see, the Stinger, he used to care about having a great match, brother. No matter where he was, brother. But the Hulkster has a philosophy, brother. Once they enter the door, you've already got their cash in your front pocket, brother. Brother. But you see, Stinger, brother, what you gonna do, brother? When I take you on a lockdown, brother.
Well, that's all we have for this episode. We'll see you next week.
Alright. Well, a little fun at Hulk Hogan, a little poking, a little fun at the Hulkster. Speaking of Hulk Hogan and Eric Bischoff present Destination X, live and exclusive on pay-per-view this Sunday night. And a short lineup thus far. But I feel like a match could be slipped in. Maybe a Kaz-Daniels match could be just slipped in there.
Well, I hope so.
We talked about a new number one contender for the X Division Championship. The British Invasion's Doug Williams puts the title on the line against Shannon Moore. Hmm. Yeah. Prediction?
Well, you know, as...
Oh, boy.
As much as I don't like Doug Williams being the champ...
We have more light, by the way.
Will Shannon Moore beat him? No chance.
I think Shannon Moore has a chaos theory or two in his future. Sorry, Shannon. You're not going to be the X Division title holder, according to the Wrestling Revolution. Brother. TNA World Tag Team Championships are on the line. Matt Morgan and Hernandez defend against the newly heel-turned Beer Money Incorporated. Prediction?
Well, my prediction is, I think with the tensions going on between the Blueprint and Supermax, I believe with this new momentum for Beer Money, I believe Beer Money Incorporated is going to be the new TNA Tag Team Champions.
You know, I agree. I mean, you saw the tension building at Against All Odds and then Hernan accepting the challenge. I feel like confrontation will end up, the two shall meet at lockdown, and because of it, new Tag Team Champions, Beer Money Incorporated.
That's right. And speaking of tag teams, our Ultimate X match is Generation Me versus the Motor City Machine Guns, and the winner of this match, JR, are the number one contenders for the TNA Tag Team titles.
So according to the Wrestling Revolution, the winner of this matchup will face Beer Money Incorporated at Lockdown. I think it's the Motor City Machine Guns to go to Lockdown, have a great match with Beer Money, yet come up short. So I think Motor City Machine Guns are going to beat the inexperienced Generation Me at Ultimate X.
I agree with you. I think it's going to be an incredible match. And, you know, the veterans will win, but just come short of getting the titles.
It is a TNA contract or leave the company for good tag team matchup for Scott Hall and Six-Pac as they take on Kevin Nash and Eric Young. It is do or die for the Wolfpack.
You know, I don't really know how to judge this one. I could go either way, really. I mean, I really don't know.
I'm going to go Hall and Waltman. Just so they can be locked in the cage next month with Young and Nash at Lockdown.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And then it is an emotional American pride-filled matchup as Kurt Angle takes on Mr. Anderson.
Anderson.
Damn.
Okay. So, this one, you got a lot of bad blood between these guys.
They have more light. Good God, we're getting lit up here and there.
Let there be light.
Let there be light.
Oh. Anyway, take your a lot of bad blood between these guys. I think it's going to be a great, I think it's going to be a good match. I see Anderson playing dirty and getting the win.
I say the same. Another rematch at Lockdown inside the formerly Six Sides of Steel. Now it's just Four Sides of Cage.
Yeah.
Which is not entertaining. Thanks, Hulk. Six Sides of Steel is gone. How about this one? Where are we at? Oh, well, we're at the main event. The TNA World Heavyweight Championship. The phenomenal styling and profiling AJ Styles defends against the Monster of the Ring, American-made Abyss.
That's right, and I think it'll be a good match. I think ultimately Hulk Hogan and Ric Flair will get involved some way, but I see AJ Styles retaining the title.
You gotta worry about Sting. He's the wild card at Destination X. What kind of a role will he play? I think AJ Styles is gonna win because the Pope is the number one contender at Lockdown. He faces the world champion. And, you know, AJ Styles, Ric Flair did a number on the ankle of the Pope, so it only makes sense that it's AJ Styles and the Pope at Lockdown for the World Heavyweight title inside the cage. Because it's also okay in St. Louis. Lockdown. Lockdown, baby.
Lockdown.
And now, in preparation for WrestleMania, we got to do some debating. Today's topic is who is the greatest WrestleMania performer of all time? Shawn Michaels. Or The Undertaker. I'll let you pick first. Brother, it's your pick, brother.
Well, let me tell you something, brother. Who is surprised that your host, this guy, is going to pick the greatest wrestler of all time?
Woo!
Not Ric Flair.
Oh, okay.
Shawn Michaels.
Then please plead your case.
My case speaks for itself. You don't come to be known as WrestleMania by not being a good performer at WrestleMania, even though your record may not even be 500. But that's beyond the point. Shawn Michaels is Mr. WrestleMania.
You're saying Shawn Michaels?
Shawn Michaels. HBK.
The main event, the icon, the showstopper, the headliner. All of the above. That leaves me Undertaker. 17-0. Jimmy Snuka, Jake the Snake, The Giant Gonzalez, King Kong Bundy, Diesel, Psycho Sid, Kane, The Big Boss Man, Triple H, Ric Randy Flair. Martin. I'm going in order here. Ric Flair, A-Train, Big Show, Kane, Randy Orton, Mark Henry, Batista, Edge, Shawn Michaels, all 17, right there. 17-0. He's beaten the best. But the question is, can he beat Shawn Michaels again and become 18-0? Only time can tell the answer to this debate. It's a short debate because we don't know the answer. The only way we can know the answer is in 18 days at WrestleMania 26 in Phoenix.
That's right, and we'll pay $15,000 out of our pocket to buy this pay-per-view.
Not $15,000, we'll pay $50.
It might as well be.
Yeah, basically. It's expensive. Guys, speaking of Shawn Michaels, though, in preparation for this matchup, the list for the next 2 weeks, including this week, including the next video, it's going to be the best matches of Shawn Michaels' career as his career on the line. Shut up. And then it will be The Undertaker's best 10 matches next week.
That's right.
Because, you know, think about it. If Taker loses at WrestleMania, is that the end of The Undertaker? Can the dead man be dead? Bum, bum, bum. All right, guys. When we come back on The Wrestling Revolution, the revolutionary winning talk show, the list, and I think we have questions to answer. Do we have questions to answer?
Yeah, I think we do.
We got questions from the best fans in the world. Think about B.
And.
Talk.
We'll show you our newly fashioned Revolutionary Awards. So.
Brother, we'll be right back. Don't go anywhere.